win this case, but this case should have never been brought. It is a political prosecution. Political prosecutions where people are targeted criminally because the prosecutors disagree with their political beliefs happen in corrupt countries. It does not happen in America. It's un-American. It should not happen here in New York City, the greatest city and the greatest democracy in the world. Should not have occurred. And it is a sad day in New York that this occurred.
Let's get more on this now with constitutional law expert Bruce DelValle in Annapolis, Maryland. He's also a litigator and founding partner of Fain and DelValle. Good to have you back with us. This marks the first criminal case against the former president's namesake company. How serious is it in your estimation?
Well, I think the charges are very, very serious. Whenever a company, let's just focus on the company charge on the Trump Organization, whenever they're indicted, it often leads to the financial ruin or the actual ruin of the company. Arthur Andersen was indicted for wrongdoing. They were eventually, convictions were overturned, but it was too late. The company failed. They just collapsed. BP has suffered and continues to suffer because of the problems it had when it was indicted for criminal prosecution for explosions on oil rigs. So it's a very serious matter for the Trump Organization. A lot of times, and certainly in this case, you can expect that banks will not want to deal with them if they're under the cloud of an investigation or criminal prosecution, not to mention what the public thinks of it. Apparently, there are people that simply won't even look at a condominium or an apartment anymore with Trump's name on it. This will further exacerbate those problems. I will say, however, if you look at these charges, like many things, what stands out is what didn't happen. Almost all of these charges are discretionary for the judge. The judge can, Mr. Weisselberg can be convicted and not serve any jail time for any of these charges. They could have charged enterprise corruption in New York, and that carries a mandatory jail sentence, mandatory. It can go up to 25 years. I think what's happening here is they want him to flip. They want him to cooperate. They charged him this way so that he gets very scared, and the only way out, his defense, the defense to every single one of these crimes is, I didn't mean to commit a crime. I was just doing what I was told.
Yes, and
if he does that,
sorry to interrupt you there, Bruce, but that does lead me to my next question, because as we know, Thursday's indictment did focus largely on the CFO, Alan Weisselberg. Is Donald Trump himself in danger of being indicted here?
Well, I don't think right now. I think right now what they're hopeful to happen, this is just the first act. This might be a three-act play. It might be a five-act play. But there's much more to come. This is a strategic indictment. As I said, they indicted very carefully here. They hope to turn Mr. Weisselberg. He's 72, 73 years old. He will not. They're hopeful, New York prosecutors are hopeful he won't fall on his sword for Mr. Trump. He'll turn state's evidence. And then they'll go after Mr. Trump, former President Trump. The big deal here is what they're trying to show is that the Trump Organization and Donald Trump inflated the value of their assets for loans and undervalued their assets for tax purposes. This second part is the first part of this puzzle. What they hope to have happen, the only way they can prove a case against former President Trump is if someone turns on him. And they're hoping that it's Mr. Weisselberg, the CFO. I think next in the crosshairs, the second act, will be going after the sons. We'll be going after Eric and Donald Jr. But this is just the beginning. It's just starting now. But I think the thing that if you look through it, you intellectually analyze this charging document, it screams what they didn't charge. If they really wanted to take down the company, they would have charged them with enterprise corruption. If they really wanted to take down Weisselberg, they would have charged him with enterprise corruption, and there would be mandatory jail sentences, and that's the end of the story. They didn't do that. Okay. They left some discretion for him to cooperate, and I think that's the sole and singular purpose of this indictment.
Okay, Bruce DelValle, we'll have to leave it there, but we always appreciate your analysis. Thank you for that.